Stevens.
All right, our next guest, so much fun because he's got fun in his last name, right? Comedian Ron Funches is performing tonight and tomorrow at Comedy at the Carlson. But first, of course, he stops here in Good Day Rochester. Good morning.
Good morning. What's a great intro. I liked it. I like that you did that with my name.
We try here, but we're so happy to have you here.
I'm happy to be here. It's a great, fun city. You guys have like a thing called a garbage plate. I feel like that's real gross. But you
did you try it?
No. I don't refuse to. But people tell me it's good, and I will take their word for it.
Yeah, so I hear.
Did you give yourself a little golf clap after
mm-hmm.
that intro?
I liked it.
I had to celebrate myself.
Yes, as you should. We should all do that more often.
Yeah, absolutely.
After we introduce ourselves.
We heard last night's show was really great.
It was great. I got a standing ovation.
Yeah, you had a lot of people
Not just this,
left.
But like standing up.
Yeah, it was great. I did a great job.
Well, I'm guessing that happens a lot, though.
It's been happening more recently. I've been getting a lot better. So it's been happening more. Things are more polished. I'm preparing for an hour special that I'm doing with Comedy Central. So this is like your chance to come and see it before it's all polished and put together, mm-hmm. if you want to. So it's like, come through. I already know it's funny. So it's like, if you don't like it, you're wrong. Yeah. You
know? Wait, hold up. An hour special with Comedy Central.
Mm-hmm.
That's like up there.
It's pretty big. Yeah, a lot of people want to do it with Netflix, but like, you know, you got to be like old and retired in comedy. To do that, and I'm still active in it, so I got to do it with Comedy Central.
Yeah. So we did, I told you we had our trivia question that we do every day in honor of you stopping mm-hmm. by, and we asked people of the four jobs listed, which ones did you not hold?
Okay.
And the choices were, one of them was a bank call center job,
mm-hmm.
Lady Liberty, and a grocery cashier, and mm-hmm. then I said radio broadcaster. And you did all of them except radio broadcaster that we know
That's
of.
True. I did actually go to a radio broadcasting workshop in uh-huh. high school. I thought about becoming a broadcaster for a while.
Wow, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So how'd you get on the path towards stand-up?
Oh, first, a lot of traumas as a child. And then later on, when I had my son, I kind of was like, oh, I need to figure out what I want to do in my life. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't really interested in anything but stand-up. And so I started open micing in Portland, Oregon. And it was a lot of trials and a lot of people booing. But
yeah, really.
I got better.
Yeah, you went through that.
I did fairly quickly, as Gabe, my friend, would say. I want to make sure I say it because he said I went right through and didn't have to do much. But
uh-huh.
I disagree.
You persevered.
Mm-hmm.
What is the key to being a good Lady Liberty?
Ooh, you gotta dance with the sign. You gotta not just dance with it and point with it, but you gotta like groove with it.
Yeah.
You gotta make people
you
feel the like
demonstrate.
Yeah. I mean, you got What you got?
Yeah. We got some paper somewhere.
Okay. Because I'm not doing it without a sign. That's just dancing. Then it's like pretty X-rated for the daytime.
Norma's crafting something right now. So to be continued.
Okay, you got two segments.
Yeah, we do. But how would you describe your shows for people who aren't familiar with you?
Oh, thank you for asking. It's pretty unique. It's a little different. I say definitely Google me. I just like to talk about me myself and the things I like. I don't really talk about like politics or like you know, a lot of people do like race jokes or whatever. I don't really do that.
You stay away from that.
I stay away from it because it doesn't interest me.
Mm-hmm.
What interests me is usually a lot about the RuPaul's Drag Race or candy or video games or Japanese wrestling. I talk about that.
Yeah.
I talk about my son a lot.
Yeah.
Talk about relationships. I'm pretty relatable as well.
Okay, we got a sign for you.
Oh.
Thanks, Norma.
Ooh, it is a good sign. Okay, I'll do it. It's fun.
Yes, do it.
Okay, so you gotta, like, you just really just want the motion of it, like a wave. Just like a wave, and then you just grooving your back.
Oh, well, I totally want to file my taxes
now.
Exactly. You gotta do this because you don't have music a lot of times you're standing out there, right?
Oh, I mean, I did. I wear my headphones and I just be just listening to just everything. Thing is me just listening to the Bee Gees, just having
the Bee Gees.
Yeah, I like a lot of things.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Oh,
that
was fun. I'm inspired to get my financial house in order now.
You should.
Yeah.
I normally would not do that for just local television, but I like
did.
You guys.
Oh, we like you too. So much. Rob, so we're going to have you stick around because we got another segment with you. We're going to talk more about some of the things that are important to you. I know one of the things you've been open about is your son, and you said you talk about him a lot during maybe some of your stand-up. So we'll talk more about that, more with Ron Funches. Fun when we come back.